Hello guys and welcome to a new video on my channel. Today I will be talking about when and how to use the directional split step. Before talking about when to use the directional split step, I will explain in detail first how to do the directional split step correctly. Just like the name suggests, you do the split step directional, to the corner you want to move. Depending on which corner you want to move, the directional split step changes a little bit. I will explain how to do the directional split step for each corner, step by step. If you want to move to the right net corner, the directional split step looks like this. You want to push off with the left leg as explosive as possible. Afterwards, you do a step-step to reach the shuttle quickly. It is important that you do the step-step after the directional split step correctly. Don't cross your legs. This is wrong. And this is correct. This is how you do the step step. I would advise you to start practicing it slowly first to make sure your steps are correct after the split step. For a good direction split step, it is very important to bring in your hip correctly. Just like I'm doing right now. For the directional split step, you want to be really mobile with your hip. You want to turn your hip really fast. To move in either corner, you want to move as quickly as possible. Now, one last time in slow motion, the right net corner. Direction split step, step step, and back to the middle. Moving on to the left net corner. If you want to move to the left net corner, you do the direction split step a little bit different. You first jump so that the right foot is pointing to the left net corner. As you can see, I turn my hip as I jump, so that my foot points to the left net corner. And then, as you land, you want to immediately push off explosively with the left leg, followed by a step step. Now again in slow motion, you jump, turn your hip, and then you land and push off explosively with the left leg, followed by the step step. Here it is very important as well to use your hip correctly and bring it in fast in the movement. Moving on to the left rear corner. For the left rear corner, the direction split step looks like this. You want to explosively push off with the right leg. Here in slow motion. In the back and rear corner, there is no sense to do a step step. You just do the normal backhand overhead footwork after the direction split step. Here it is important as well to bring in the hip fast in the movement, just as shown. If you want me to do a video on how to do the correct overhead footwork as we professionals do it, then comment down below and I will do a tutorial on the correct overhead footwork. I will also include the correct backhand footwork for the rear corner. Moving on to the last corner of the court, the right rear corner. For the right rear corner, the split step looks like this. You want to explosively push off with the left leg, then afterwards do a step step or a crossover. For the forehand, there exists different kinds of correct footwork depending on the situation. But this video will focus on the directional split step only. The fastest version for the right rear corner after the directional split step would be the step step. Also in this corner, remember to bring the hip in the movement just as shown. That's it for the explanation part. If you have still any open questions left regarding the directional split step, the movement, then comment down below and I will do my best to answer your open questions. That being said, I wanted to answer a question from my last footwork video, because answering that question will help you guys understand when to use the directional split step. In my last footwork video, one of you guys asked, how can you do the directional split step when you don't have enough time to react, because you don't know where the shot is coming? Well, the answer to that is quite simple. It's one word: anticipation. You decide how you want to position your feet in order to move faster into two corners, even before your opponent hit the shuttle. That allows you to move extremely fast into two corners. Now you might be saying, but Camillo, two corners? That's dumb. I want to move into four corners extremely fast. The court has four corners. I want to be able to move into four corners quickly. Well, it's true that with a neutral stance, shown right here, you can move to all four corners in the court equally fast. Or how I would say equally slow, but not extremely fast, as you could when choosing two corners you want to cover and adjusting your feet so that you can use the directional split step. Let me explain why choosing two corners is a wise decision over choosing four corners moving okay-ish fast. To explain this, let's just take this rally as an example. I'm serving in this rally, but I decide to not adjust my feet after the serve to the middle in a neutral stance, which would look like this, parallel legs, but instead, as you can see in the video, I stand diagonal, my right foot in front, my left foot in the back. I could have changed my feet to a neutral stance, but I decided to not to do that. Why did I decide to do that? At first sight, this may seem dumb, to not adjust your feet to be able to equally move fast into all the four corners. But by not adjusting my feet, I am able to move extremely fast into two corners, like I said. In this example, the rear backhand corner and the forehand net corner. By having this diagonal stance, I am saving time, because I do not need time to adjust my hip to move into those two corners. Normally, I would need to first turn my hip when I would want to move to the backhand corner, when I have a neutral stance, or the forehand net corner, or basically any corner of the court, I would need to turn my hip, which costs time. In this example, I decide to save up time for my movement to the backhand rear corner and the forehand net corner, because I believe that my opponent will choose to play into one of those two corners. With this diagonal stance, my hip is already positioned so that I can move quickly into either the rear backhand corner or the forehand net corner. I chose that stance, like I said, because I anticipated a shot to my backhand rear corner or the forehand net corner. In this example, I am right and my opponent actually plays a net shot into the area I was anticipating. But what if I would have been wrong? Well, in that case, I would need to turn my hip and adjust my feet so that I am able to move into the corners I did not anticipate. In this example, my forehand rear corner and the backhand net corner. When you have a diagonal stance, you basically cover two corners only. Whereas when having a neutral stance, you basically don't cover any corner of the court. You just stand, waiting for something to happen. Downside to covering two corners extremely fast is that the other two corners, you won't be able to move that fast like the two corners you are covering. But it's better to cover two corners than cover nothing with a neutral stance. If your opponent plays a shot into a corner you were not covering with the diagonal stance, then you will be forced to adjust your feet and hip, which will cost time, which results in being late at the shuttle. You have to imagine the direction split step basically as a gamble. With experience, your anticipation gets better automatically. Basically, you have to know that with the directional split step, you will be always faster than with the normal split step, which is why you want to use the directional split step at all times, because it's the fastest way to move on court. There are a few occasions where you should not use it, but in majority of the cases, you should use the direction split step. Majority does not mean always. The big weakness of the direction split step is that you cannot cover smashes with it. That means that whenever you lift high enough that your opponent has the time to smash, you are forced to take a neutral stance to be able to defend against the smash. Because it's impossible to defend against a smash with a direction split step. Because the direction split step is designed to move into a corner, not to the sides. So whenever your opponent has enough time to attack, take a neutral stance to be able to defend against a smash. But if your opponent has not the time to play an attacking shot, then always gamble and adjust your feet so that you cover two corners of the court. Which two corners? You have to decide by yourself. It depends on the situation which two corners are more wise to choose to cover. You can decide which corners you want to cover a little bit by logic. If you want me to do a video about helping you anticipating shots to be able to move faster on court through anticipation, to give you some tips to help you improve anticipate shots, then leave a comment down below and I will do a video about that. In this video, I want to cover just everything about the direction split step. I think the video already is an XXL format. It does not matter if your anticipation or guess, call it whatever you want, was wrong. Quickly adjusting the feet diagonal the other way and using the direction split step will make you still faster than moving using the normal split step. Always remember that. The normal split step is mostly used when you are in a defensive position and when you don't know if your opponent will attack or not. Well, that's it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. As always, leave feedback in the comments down below. Any open questions left regarding the direction split step, comment down below as well. And I will do my best to answer your open questions. And with that being said, see you guys in the next video.